know, I was falling asleep behind the wheel. I couldn't think right, and my brain was just shutting down on me. And I was gaining weight, and I was never had any energy, falling asleep all the time.
So I met Al when he was referred to my practice to evaluate him for surgical management of his obstructive sleep apnea. The untreated severe sleep apnea is linked to a whole host of problems, including cardiovascular events like heart attacks, strokes, cardiac arrhythmias, high blood pressure, diabetes, poor work performance, motor vehicle accidents, and all-cause mortality. So it really has dramatic repercussions if it's untreated. So he really didn't have another option to treat his sleep apnea besides surgery. It was so severe that it was placing him at risk for significant health problems.
I was just happy that there was an option that didn't contain the CPAP mask, which wasn't working. So I didn't really comprehend at that time the severity of the surgery. I just heard that we could have surgery and it might fix it, and that would do it. I'm like, okay.
The surgery that Al had is called maxillomandibular advancement, and it essentially means that we advance both jaws and sometimes the chin to give better projection to the face. And essentially, by moving the foundation or the skeleton of the face forward, we enlarge the airway or the breathing tube at multiple levels so that when you lie flat, the tube is larger and it's more resistant to blocking off during sleep.
If you're not dreaming and you're just barely surviving and stuff, this is an option. Mm-hmm. I used to have heartburn more often after that surgery. My heartburn situation went away.
His blood pressure immediately got under control, yeah, which was amazing and awesome.
And my weight went down. Looking back at it and stuff, I had no other choice. It was, you know, it added years to my life. The quality of my life is better. I'm not sure where I would be if we didn't have that surgery.